correct cage around your joint to move it. If you have here selected world coordinate system, then you get a few problems to move the object correctly. It's better in object mode. Okay, that was our first scene. What I now want to show is you also can use the pose mixer with that. Let's grab the pose mixer here. We have chosen the bone. That's our default position. We add this position to the pose mixer as default position. Now we can say this is our up position. We add it, call it up, and now we choose this position as down. Now it's easier to animate this. Let's get handle, both handles for this. And if we now drag here on this slider, it goes up, and here it goes down. Now it's a little bit easier to animate. Well, let's choose the parent skeleton. Make this a little bit smaller. And say we want to turn it to this side. We record this. Turn it back to this side. Record this. And now we choose these bones. Give me my handle. So first we want to go up. Record this. And we want to go down. And re-record this. So, let's play back. Looks great. Well, fast and easy. Okay, let's load the next scene. Let's say we have a hydraulic system or want to create a hydraulic system. How can we achieve that? Also, quite easy. Go in wireframe mode, side view, and let's create a new skeleton. This should be our parent skeleton with what we move the complete object. We can put this handle out so that it's a little bit bigger. But we attach only the cube onto this bone. Why? I explain later. And let's nail that. Create a new skeleton. And this is for our cylinder here on the front. And attach the cylinder to this bone. Now, the same as before, this is our complete handle skeleton, parent skeleton. Drag the other skeleton with the right mouse button, drag it to the bone and drop it. Okay, now go to the animate page. We have opened our pose mixer. Choose this skeleton for the cylinder at the default pose and move it into the cube and add this and let's call it in. So that's all. We have nothing more to do. We can now choose our parent and animate him, and we can also choose the in and can move that in and out with our pose mixer. Let's rotate that view a little bit and say okay, let it be in and go back out and let's play back. quite easy. Okay. Last scene. This mechanical thing here is a little bit more difficult, but not so much. Let's say this is a part of the small Luxo lamp from the small lamp from Pixar's movie trailer. One part of it. How can we do that? Okay. Let's go onto the side view, front view, front view. And let's start again with a new skeleton. Let's move this joint up and this one to this side. From here, let's create a new bone. Move it to this side. The same from this joint here, new bone, drag it to the side, and now we connect this joint onto this joint. We have selected this joint, choose the connect button, press connect onto this joint, we have connected it. So let's start with this bone. It's bone 3. Cube 3 is this blue cube. Let's drag it with the left mouse button, drop it. Okay, this is bone 2, and now we need cube 1. Left mouse button, drag it, drop it. Okay, this here is bone 1, and we need cube for bone 1, and the last is the blue cube here for the last bone. Again, the same. At last, let us nail this joint and this joint, and that's all. Go to the Animate tab and let's see what we have. We can now move and animate this kind of technical thing quite easy. And it's working very well. Okay, that's all for today. I hope I see you next time when I will explain a few more tricks about Motion Studio and animating with TrueSpace. Thanks a lot.